because this video is about in response to some of the comments that were on my Africans did Africans sell other Africans, and this is in particularly in response to a white person, a white woman, who came on my page named La Cassini. And for those who are looking at this video, you can go look at the comments of that video to get the references to what I'm talking about. But I did jot some notes down so that I wouldn't forget what I was saying, because I don't have a lot of time. I am on my lunch hour at work. But first of all, she started off saying that her black friends, she feels as though that when her black friends bring up stuff, you know, about slavery and stuff, that she feels as though they're trying to evoke some kind of guilt from her. And my response to that, you can read my response to that. I don't think they're trying to evoke guilt. That's you feeling like that. You feel as though you should have some, and you're probably a little disturbed with yourself because you don't. Okay. And then, but what I really want to focus on in your commentary is that you say that you haven't received anything, because I talked about your privilege, and you said that you haven't received anything. You're from a military family. You have debt from college, and that you've been discriminated, sexually harassed when you was in New York City. So I guess where you are now, you're not sexually harassed. And you said that you don't want to say that we're the same, but we aren't too far different. And I'm going to say to you that we're very different. And I think I did say that there are big differences in our relationship in America. And those cannot be discounted. You also went to talking about slavery in Central America and Mexico and all those types of places, which I find real interesting. When black people go to talking about their Holocaust or their Ma'afa, people always bring up what happened to other people. Not only that, you also said, which I found really striking, was that you also said that you want to know how, when you have the many that did die from Spanish abuse or smallpox that were made into slaves by these officers, you want to ask how come they are integrated so well, yet in the U.S. it's brought up time and time again. And you're talking about why we haven't been integrated into this system. Well, let me first say that what you received is not physical. It's mental. It's a mental privilege. It is the mental privilege that you have been given in America. Everything in America is measured by you. Every disparity that black people have is contrasted to yours. We can't read as good as the white kid. We don't get jobs as much as that. We're more unemployed than white people. We're more this, we're more that. So when we talk about the African slave trade, it was a process. It wasn't just an event. It is a process that has led up to right now. Whereas in the system of white supremacy, that process that was put in place called enslavement, that evolved into something called Jim Crow, and then we went to fighting discrimination because of a mentality had developed about stereotypes about white people about black people to white people, which kept them at feeling as though they're better than black people, another human being, so much so that they could enslave them. And then once released, they were either still looked upon as savages, or beneficently as those poor black people, which made you our benefactors. You know, so there's a process in what happened to black people. And I kind of jotted down some things that I wanted to share. And like I said, the slavery, the trade, Atlantic slave trade had a mentality. It created a mentality, not just a mentality of black people, but it also created a mentality in white people. And this is why it's difficult for most white people to look at the disparities in employment, health, prison, education between the races, because you don't understand the process. You don't understand the process that use you. You know what I'm saying? That keeps you at a level where, you know, you feel you got one up. At least you ain't as bad as black folks. You know what I'm saying? I done seen some white folks, poets, Job, nasty, raggedy, think they better than me. Well, have the audacity and the unmitigated gall to call me a nigger. And they are the ones looking like and smelling like a nigger, living like a nigger. Okay? But simply because they're white, they can have that mentality that they're better than me. And I could be a millionaire, a billionaire like Oprah, or a president like Obama. Because like I tell everybody, you catch them on a dark Mississippi road at night, they ain't going to be nothing but a nigger. Okay? I don't care who they are. On a back road in Alabama, Mississippi, sometimes New York City, all up in Minnesota, Wisconsin, wherever it is, where there's a majority of white people, you bring your black ass through there at a certain amount of time, and they don't give a damn who you are. To them, you're the enemy. All right? And this is a certain class of white people that have that mentality. Now, you got another class that do their thing a little different. They sit behind desks and exclude based on their own stereotypes of black people. But you said that you haven't received anything, and that you have debt, and that you have debts, and it's all about you. But see, it's not all about you. For us, it's about a system that's bigger than you, the one little white person who have all these debts like everybody else, or all other races of people in America. We have all those debts as well. So it's bigger than your debt and your being sexually harassed. Because as far as you being sexually harassed, I mean, black women are harassed wholesale. It's black women, for the most part, can't even say they're being raped. They gotta prove beyond a shadow of a doubt. All you gotta do is scream. We gotta damn near take a picture of the perpetrator actually raping us, have a video before somebody believes us. But for you, it's easier because you're white. I'm telling you, you have privileges because you're white. Tim Wise talks about white privilege, but he don't never talk about giving it up. But he definitely talks about it. And so, you know, like I'm saying to you, the privileges that you have, or those that have been provided to you, are so deep in the fabric of this country that you don't even pay it any attention. See, the thing about it is you don't even think about being white. The first thing you said was, I'm white. I mean, that was the first thing that you said. In your first email to me, I think the first thing you said was, this is what you said: I'm happy to see someone discussing this topic. I'm a white, Italian, German person. You didn't say you was a Italian, German. The first thing you said was you was white. So that gives me an indicator that you have a intrinsic understanding of your privilege, because the first thing you said was that you're white. You identified yourself as white. And I suggest you read Dr. Neely Fuller's book as well. He wrote a book on how to beat white supremacy. Because it ain't just a fight for black people. It's a fight for your ass, too, if you really want the truth. But anyway, what white people really don't understand is how many black people who are affected because of the system of white supremacy, because we look at the Oprahs and we look at the Obamas, but we also need to look at Tiger Woods. Tiger Woods is the poster boy now for dysfunctional sexual activities. When people are